Hi viewers, in this session we are going to see unit 3 of engineering chemistry, that is polymers and composites. And we cannot imagine modern life without polymers, because the polymers are used as a basic material from carry bag to rocket and rocket fuels. So let us see what you mean by polymer. Polymer is a macromolecule that is having very high molecular weight, formed by the combination of large number of small molecules, which are called as monomers. So polymers are macromolecules formed by the combination of large number of small molecules. So the small molecules which are combined to form polymer is called monomer. It is having very low molecular weight. So let us see an example for a polymer. Here I am taking ethylene as a small molecule. Of course it is a gas. Large number of ethylene molecules combines to give a macromolecule with a very high molecular weight. This is called as polymer. So this is ethylene, is a monomer. Combines to form polyethylene or polyethylene. In both the ways we can call. This is a polymer, right? So polymers are the macromolecules formed by the combination of large number of small molecules. The small molecules are called as monomers. And here is an example: ethylene is a monomer, combines to give polyethylene, is a polymer. Now, what type of compounds will act as a monomer? So if you want to get a polymer, you need to get a monomer. So the monomers are the substances which are having some reactive sites. So only when there is some reactive site or reactive functional group, they can combine to form polymer. See, monomers are compounds with low molecular weight. They are small molecules, contain at least two reactive sites or reactive functional groups. Monomers are the compounds with low molecular weight, contain at least two reactive sites or two reactive functional groups. Here I am taking ethylene as an example. It is having two reactive sites, so it can combine on either side and to give a bigger molecule called polymer. And the other example I am taking is ethylene glycol. So it is a reactive, it is having two reactive functional groups. So some other monomer like dicarboxylic acid having some other reactive group. So again it has two reactive functional groups. So these two can combine to give a polymer, or this molecule ethylene can combine itself in large number to give polymer. So monomers are the compounds with low molecular weight, contain at least two reactive sites or two reactive functional groups. Here are the examples. And next one is, what is the functionality of the monomer? A monomer may contain two reactive sites or it may contain more than two. Accordingly, they are classified under the term functionality. So when you are taking this ethylene, it is having two reactive sites, so it is bifunctional. So before that, let me define what is functionality. So functionality is nothing but number of reactive sites or reactive groups present in a monomer is called functionality. So in the case of ethylene, we have two reactive sites. When you are taking ethylene glycol, it is having two reactive functional groups. Again, its reactive functionality is two. And this terephthalic acid, we are going to see in future, it is having two reactive functional groups. Its functionality is again two. Right? So far we have discussed about polymers, monomers, functionality of the monomers. Next, let us move to polymerization. What do you mean by polymerization? It is just similar to the wreathing of flower. To get a garland, large number of flowers combines to give a single thing, that is called our garland. In the same way, in polymerization, large number of molecules are tied together, that is combined together, to give a single bigger molecule, that is called polymer. So polymerization is nothing but large number of small molecules. How will you call the small molecules? The small molecules are nothing but our monomers. So large number of small molecules combine to form a single bigger molecule, that is our polymer. So polymerization is nothing but the chemical reaction by which large number of small molecules combines to form single bigger molecule, that is called polymerization. So the example, best example we can take is ethylene, as we have seen earlier. Large number of molecules of ethylene combines to give polythene. See this N here. This is N number of discrete units combines to give a chain having N such units. So in this polymer chain, N, this unit repeated for N times. So number of times this unit getting repeated in a polymer chain is called degree of polymerization. So degree of polymerization is nothing but how many times that particular unit is getting repeated in that polymer chain, that is called degree of polymerization. And this N value is deciding the overall characteristic property of a polymer. Especially, it is playing vital role in mechanical properties of polymer. In case of the N value is very high, then you will get a very high molecular weight polymer. That is, its molecular weight ranges between 10 power 4 to 10 power 6. Imagine. See the molecular weight of ethylene, how small it is. When you calculate its molecular weight, so for 2 carbon 24 plus 4, you will be getting only 28. See the molecular weight of this compound, 10 power 4, 10,000. Imagine. So how bigger the polymer is? Because of its high molecular weight, we are having that polymer in solid state. Ethylene is a gas, whereas polythene is a solid. So only because of its high molecular weight, there is change in physical state. So if the degree of polymerization, that is the N value, is very large, you will be getting a polymer with very high molecular weight. They are called as high polymers. So high polymers are having N value very large. In case if a polymer is having small N value, we won't get any such high polymer. You will be getting a polymer of low molecular weight. They are called as oligomers. So oligomers are the polymers having very low N value. And of course, these oligomers are not having that much mechanical importance, because oligomers, since they have very low molecular weight, so they don't have such mechanical strength, so that is not having that much application as far as this curse is concerned. So polymerization, large number of small molecules combined to form single bigger molecule, that is called polymerization. This is an example, and this is n value, that is called our degree of polymerization. Degree of polymerization is nothing but number of times the monomeric unit repeats in that polymer chain, right? As I said earlier, if n value is very high, you will be getting high polymer. It is having the molecular weight in the range of 10 power 4 to 10 power 6. In case if n value is very less, you will be getting oligomer. That's all about this. Actually, in this nomenclature, we are not going to see the actual naming of polymers. Here, how the polymers are classified, that alone we are going to see. So, there are two broad categories. One is homopolymers, copolymers. In homopolymers, the monomers which are combined to give polymer are of single type. So that is a single type of monomer combines to give polymer. Now you can give example very well from the thing which I quote earlier. That is ethylene, a single type of monomer, that is one monomer, combines to give a polymer, polyethylene. So this is an example for homopolymer. So only one type of monomer combines to give the polymer. Whereas in the next category, copolymer, different types, that is more than one type of monomer combines to give the polymer. So the best trick, that is here, different types combines to form polymer. So the best example we can take here for copolymer is SBR, that is styrene butadiene rubber. It is a very important polymer. Here the two monomers, one is styrene, other one is butadiene, different types combines to form a polymer, that is styrene butadiene rubber. It is an example for copolymer. So let me give the structure of the styrene butadiene rubber. So this is the structure of styrene polymerized with butadiene. We are getting a polymer. This is styrene butadiene rubber. It is an important and interesting copolymer. So that in this nomenclature we have seen two types, homopolymer and copolymer, with respect to examples. Next one, when you take a polymer chain, that polymer chain made up of only by carbon, or that polymer chain may contain some heteroatom in it. On that basis, it is classified into two types. That is, the polymer chain may be made up of only by carbon. That skeleton may carry only carbon, or it may carry carbon, oxygen, like that. It may have some heteroatom along the chain. If it is made up of only by carbon chain, carbon atom, that is the polymer skeleton, that is the backbone of the polymer, is made up of only by carbon, then such polymer is called as homochain polymer. So this is a polymer chain is made up of only one type of atom, that is homochain. In case if the polymer chain carries some heteroatom besides carbon, that is heterochain polymer. That is polymer chain made up of only by one atom. Mostly that atom is going to be carbon, because polymers are mainly organic. So we have some inorganic polymer as well, but we are not moving to that. Whereas in heteroatom, polymer chain is made up of more than one atom. That is besides carbon, with carbon you may have nitrogen or oxygen may present along the polymer chain. So homo chain polymer, the chain is made up of only by carbon atom, whereas hetero chain polymer, the chain is made up of nitrogen and oxygen besides carbon. So let me take suitable example for this. The homo chain polymer, no need to mention any example because we have seen good lot of example earlier. Anyhow, ethylene polymerizes to give, or for the sake of novelty, let me take some other compound, that is vinyl chloride polymerizes to give polyvinyl chloride. See here, that polymer chain is made up of only by carbon atom. It is a homo chain polymer. Whereas in hetero chain polymer, I am taking that well known interesting polymer, that is PET polyester. We are going to see elaborately about this later. Anyhow, for the sake of example, I am giving here. This is an acid, dicarboxylic acid, name is terephthalic acid, combines with ethylene glycol, and we are getting a polymer. See here, besides carbon, the carbon skeleton is having a hetero atom oxygen. Next, let us move to the polymerization types. Now let us move on to types of polymerization. So we know already about polymerization. As I said earlier, it is like wrapping of flowers, that is large number of small molecules combines to form a single bigger one polymer. So here we have three types of polymerization. That is, first one is addition polymerization, next one is condensation polymerization, and the last one is copolymerization. Let us see one by one. See the term addition polymerization, the term itself self-explanatory. That is, the molecules, monomer molecules, are added with one another. You know the meaning of addition? The molecules are added with one another. Let me move from example to definition. So ethylene, large number of ethylene molecules combines to give a single bigger molecule polyethylene. Just to compare these two. So the structural identity of the monomer is retained here. That means what? Nothing has eliminated during the formation of polymer. So addition polymerization is nothing but the monomers added with one another, forming polymer without the elimination of any small molecules like water, HCl, etc. And what type of monomers can undergo this type of polymerization? So normally this addition reaction is possible only when there is unsaturation. So here ethylene is the best example for having unsaturation. So the monomers would contain monomers containing at least one double or triple bond alone can. Right? So addition polymerization, the molecules, or otherwise we can say olefinic monomers, or we can say unsaturated monomers, monomers having double or triple bond, undergoes polymerization, giving the polymer without any elimination of small molecules like water or HCl. In this case, the structural identity of monomer is retained in the polymer. Next one is condensation polymerization. So condensation polymerization is possible only when the monomer contain the reactive functional groups like OH or acid or amino group. Here I am taking a compound having reactive or polar functional groups. Ethylene glycol is the best example having two reactive functional groups. Another one is terephthalic acid. So these can undergo condensation polymerization. See, in this case, small molecule like water or ammonia is eliminated. In this case, molecule of water is eliminated. This is PET, that is terylene, we know. Its chemical name is polyethylene terephthalate. It is abbreviated as PET. We will see elaborate later under individual polymers. Here is just to compare the monomers and the polymer. The structural identity is not exactly repeated because of the elimination of small molecule water. Whereas in this case, no such elimination occurs. Now, the third type, copolymerization. We are not going in detail about copolymerization. I am taking the copolymerization of addition polymerization. So addition polymerization can be carried out by taking only one type of monomer or more than one type. So here I am taking, it is copolymerization is the polymerization of two different monomers. The example for copolymerization we have seen already, that is styrene butadiene, SBR. Now let us concentrate on these two, that is addition polymerization and condensation polymerization, and let us differentiate these two. See, some of the differences between addition and condensation polymerization we have seen in the definition part itself. Anyhow, let us summarize it. So the first one is, addition polymerization is possible with unsaturated monomers with double or triple bonds. Whereas this condensation polymerization is possible with monomers containing reactive functional group, like here let me give an example. So ethylene, acetylene and vinyl chloride are some of the monomers of this category which can give addition polymer. This is acetylene, which is going to give polyacetylene. It is not coming under our area. Monomers containing reactive functional group like our ethylene glycol, or for some other example also we can take, that is adipic acid, because this acid, adipic acid, we are going to use in the preparation of nylon 6,6, and the other monomer is hexamethylene diamine. Often we may confuse with the name hexamethylene diamine from hexamethylene tetramine, so be careful while writing the name. So the second difference is, as I said earlier, in this case no byproduct is eliminated, that is no byproduct or no small molecule is eliminated. During the polymerization, no small molecule like water, HCl are not eliminated. Whereas in this case, small molecules like HCl and water eliminated. See, the third difference is, structural identity of the monomer is retained. Since no small molecule is eliminated, the molecules are added with one another, so structural identity of the monomer is exactly repeated or retained in the polymer, and thereby the molecular mass, therefore the molecular mass of the polymer, molecular weight of the polymer is equal to the integral multiple of monomers present are taken. Whereas in the other case, since the structural identity is lost, because of the elimination of small molecules, the structural identity is not retained, therefore the molecular mass or weight, anyway you can say, weight is not equal to the integral multiple of monomers present. So the monomer concentration decreased in the initial stage itself. Whereas in the other case, there is a steady decrease in monomer concentration. Here monomer concentration decreased in the initial stage itself. That means, doesn't mean that all the monomers are converted into polymer in the initial stage itself. Since the addition polymerizations are taking place either through, we are going to see later, ionic or free radical polymerization, the first stage itself, all the monomers are converted into reactive links. By this polymerization, we are getting mainly thermoplastics. Thermoplastics are the plastics which can be softened by heating. The best example we can take is polyethylene or polyvinyl chloride. So thermoplastics are obtained, whereas in this case we are getting thermosetting plastics. Thermosetting plastics are the plastics which cannot be softened by heating, and thereby they cannot be remolded. We are going to see the next part giving you thermosetting plastics like bakelite. Here we can take the examples like PVC or polythene. We have good lot of examples of either category. So like that we can go on differentiating the polymers. So here are the five differences.